Mary Ann Hansen. I am an extension plant pathologist with Virginia Cooperative Extension and the Virginia Tech Plant Disease Clinic. And today we're going to discuss the disease called boxwood blight. Because there's no way to cure an infected plant, the fungus remains on infected plants. And even if the symptoms are not very obvious and maybe the plant leafs out again and initially the leaves look green, that fungus is there, and under the right conditions it can produce spores and cause new symptoms. So really, if you have the disease diagnosed on your property, it's not going to go away on those plants. So ideally you would remove the infected plants and all of the leaf debris that has dropped under those plants, which can be a pretty difficult process. And ideally you would double bag those plants and take them to the landfill. It doesn't make any sense to drag those plants to the roadside and let them sit there waiting for pickup, because in the meantime a lot of the dead leaves can blow to other properties, and as we know, the fungus can survive in those dead leaves. So it's really helpful to get all that plant debris off the property. There are landscapers who now specialize in mitigating boxwood blight, and they will come and bag up your plants. Some of them even shrink wrap the plants and remove them from the property, and they will vacuum up all the leaf debris. This is a really good way of getting the pathogen off your property. Of course, boxwood leaves are so small that often there can be some leaf debris remaining on your property. And if you replant boxwood or a susceptible plant like Pachysandra in those beds, then you run the risk of getting the disease occurring again. So one thing that can help to prevent that, if you really want to plant boxwood back in those areas, is to mulch over the soil surface. So that will provide a barrier between the dead leaves and the plants. And research has shown that a lot of infection does occur from those dead leaves underneath the plants. So if you provide that mulch layer, that can prevent that sort of infection. And also, plant-resistant varieties in there if you're going to replant boxwood. Remember that if you are trying to remove boxwood blight infected plants from your property, you will probably also want to remove any Pachysandra or Sarcococca. Even if they're not showing symptoms, they are susceptible. So if you're really trying to remove it, you'll want to remove those plants as well. And if you are using pruning tools or other equipment in infected plantings, you want to make sure to sanitize that equipment. If you've got pruning tools, you want to dip them in a sanitizer. So those sanitizer wipes, that's not enough for sanitizing a tool. Refer to the Boxwood Blight Task Force website, which has lists of sanitizers and tells you how long you need to dip the tool for that sanitizer to be effective. Usually it's between 5 to 10 minutes. But before you sanitize the tool, make sure you've washed off any soil or plant debris, because the sanitizer won't be very effective if you've still got a lot of infected leaves or plant debris on the tool. So clean your tool and then sanitize.